Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about the architecture of GSM. In the previous video, we have already discussed what is GSM and what are its services. Now, this architecture, GSM architecture, is one of the very important concepts in GSM. So, if you see or if you look into the diagram in your screen, it consists of three different subsystems. When you look into the diagram, it may look like a very complex diagram, but it's a very simple diagrams. So the first section into this one is a radio subsystem. So here you can see it is marked here. I will take a pencil and it will be easier for me to mark it. Here you see this part, we call it as a radio subsystem. Correct. Now you see here, we got BTS, that is what we call tower, MS, what we call our mobile stations, our stations which are our handsets. And here, as you see, this BTS, it is forming one cell here. Like that, there are multiple cells are there, and each of these are connected with the BSC. What are these things we will discuss? So this part, if you take the topmost part of the GSM architecture, is called as a radio subsystem, RSS. Next comes network subsystem. So this part, so I cannot this one, some mixed parts are there, so here it is very difficult to discuss. Okay, only this much, wait for a minute to clear these things. Okay, this part you see here, VLR, HAR, this part is there, no? This part is called as the network switching subsystem. And the last one is called as a operation subsystem, EIR, AUC, OMC. This part is called as a operation subsystems. Now, let us discuss one by one. See, I have one diagram here, and I want to keep this diagram also. Okay. Now see here, I will discuss one by one in this architecture. So the three different subsystems, main subsystems are there. One is radio subsystems, network switching subsystem, and operation subsystems. Now one by one we will discuss. See here in this diagram, it is showing here up to this one, it is RSS from here to here, and next is NSS, network switching subsystem, then OSS, that is operations subsystem. So what are these things inside this, what this MS, BTS and all these things, and what are its features, we will discuss one by one. If you take it a full diagram, it may look like a complex, but if you just split it into the parts. So this particular diagram what I have placed here, it is not there in your textbook or in your notes. If you want, you can note down this by pausing the video. For convenience of the explanation, and I have just split this into three different parts. So I have, in this whole diagram, I have just split it. I have picked this from Google. Here you see the diagram. What you see here is see here, in this part is a radio subsystem, okay, and this part is a network switching subsystem. So if you see into this diagram, the radio subsystem is connected to the MSC, that is a mobile switching center. So what are these things, we will discuss one by one. So it is like the hierarchy. Here hierarchy in the sense, first at the top you can take a GSM. Below that comes three sections: radio subsystem, networking switching system, and operating system. And in one of the section, that is in radio subsystem, we have four important concepts to discuss. See here, if you look into this diagram, one point is not mentioned here, that is BSC. That part is in our diagram. Okay, so actually this is the diagram what is picked from your textbook, and this is a diagram what I have picked from Google. Now, let us discuss about a mobile station. In general, in single line, you can write the definition for this. Mobile station means the handset what you are using is a mobile station. So what your mobile station will include or your handset will include? Only two things, a major two things. One is subscriber identity module, that is SIM. Many of us are talking about SIM, but we don't know what is SIM. SIM stands for subscriber identity module. Who is a subscriber? I am a subscriber. If I take a mobile and I take a SIM of particular network such as Airtel or Jio or a BSNL, then I will become a subscriber of that particular network. So it will have a, they will provide me the SIM. With that SIM I can connect with their network. So it has two features. One is the subscriber identity model, that is the SIM card what we insert in our mobile, and the mobile services such as Airtel, Jio. These are the services what are provided by these handsets. Next comes the base station subsystem. So actually base station subsystem, here in this diagram you can see BSS what we call. It has BTS and BSC. It contains BTS and BSC. BSC stands for base station controller and BTS stands for base transceiver station. So these two topics are discussed here. Okay. Now we will start with the BTS, that is a base transceiver station. It has a radio equipment such as antenna and all. So in general, if you have to discuss, BTS is a technical term. We call it as a mobile tower. And in the previous diagram itself we have seen. So each cell is formed by this BTS, correct? And inside this particular cell you will have a mobile station source. Correct. This is what we see in the complete diagram of architecture, mobile architecture. So this mobile tower, so what it will include in general terms, it will include a antenna. So antenna will be a transponder, means it will have both transmitter as well as receiver. What is transponder? We have discussed in the first unit. And it will have a signal processor to send or receive the signals to the mobile station. Correct. Here you can see, in this particular part you can see BTS is connected with the mobile station. Means when we are in the network, we will be always, MS means we are, the one person who is using a mobile handset is a MS, that is a mobile station. We will be always connected to the BTS, you know that concept. And it will have an amplifier to amplify the signals. So these are the general concept, isn't it? It can be easily understood or remember that what is a BTS. BTS, if you remember a tower, you just connect it with the technical term, that is a BTS, base transceiver station. Transceiver means what? It has both transmitter as well as receiver. For that what it is using? Transformer is an antenna here. Okay, it is used for signal processing. Correct. And it has an amplifier or to amplify the signals. Means to amplify the data which is transmitted over this is done by the amplifiers. Next, we will discuss about BSC, that is base station controller. Actually base station controller is it is managing a radio resources of BTS. Means whatever the signals are sent to your tower, these signals are radio signals. Okay, these are managed by BSC, base station controller. Whatever signals are sent to your, means what, when you do the calling, when you do the data transfer, that will be done between your mobile station and BTS. And it is managed by BSC, that is base station controller. And it senses, BTS sense that it assigns a frequency and a time slot for all the mobile stations in the area. So I repeat the sentence again. The BCS manages the radio resources of BTSs. Means radio resources means what you are here? So radio signals what are sent or received by the BTS, that is our tower, in the sense that it assigns a frequency and the time slot to all the mobile stations in the area. So this was regarding the radio subsystem. By splitting this into two sections or a part of the architecture, it made my explanation easier. Now before going to the next slide, I want to share a small point here. So here you see BSS, that is BSS covers BTS and BSC, and when it connects with the networks, other network, so the next part is a network and switching subsystem. So we know that we are not limited to one network. We can switch between network. We can share the data. When user moves from one network to another network also, he is not disconnected. Correct. And how it is done? For that, actually it is possible because your BSC is connected to the MSC, and this MSC is connected to one more MSC, that is mobile switching center, and that connects to the mobile BSC of the another network. In brief, I am telling what are these things and how it is done, and all these things we will be discussing in the third chapter, how it is in hands off and how all these things are done in detail we will be discussing. Okay, we will not discuss these things in the architecture now, otherwise the length of the video will be increased. Now let us discuss about network and switching subsystem. Okay, here you see this is the part of the RSS. Okay, you see BSC is connected to MSC. Two BSCs are shown. These two BSCs are of two different cells or a network. Correct. These are connected to MSC, the mobile switching center, and it has HLR, VLR, EIR, and AOC. Then it is also connected with the PSTN and PSPDN, which are our wired networks. Okay, about those things we will discuss. Okay, now in this part, so EIR is coming under the operation subsystem, so we will not discuss EIR here, AUC is also coming under operation subsystem. Means above this, only this much we will discuss in this one. Okay, now let us discuss about what is a network and switching subsystem. It's a heart of the GSM, you can call, and it has actually, it is used to connect with the wired network. That is what we can see here. That is a PSTN. And it carries out the usage based on charging, accounting, and also handling the roaming. So when you use your network, so your data is maintained, isn't it? Data of usage of your database. Means if you take 2GB network plan in Jio or any other network, after 2GB automatically it is disconnected. You are disconnected with that plan. Correct. And previously there was no packages such as this 2GB packages and all. Then your data rate was counted on your usage. So 1 hour, if you use 100 MB, if you are using in 3G and all, it was charged, it was disconnected, it was deducted from your balance, maybe a voice balance or maybe your data balance. So all these type of charging and accounting facilities are done in this one. Where it is done we will discuss. Now let us discuss one by one. Now MSC, and also it is mentioned it is dealing with the roaming also, we will discuss that. MSC, MST stands for mobile switching center. It sets up a connection, as I have discussed with PDN, that's a wired network and all, and it's also capable of a connection setup between the two different networks and release that connection, and it also helps us to have a call handoff. That means call handoff means when you are switching from a room, when you are roaming and when you are switching from one network to another, it will be helpful. Next, there is one more concept in mobile switching, that is a gateway MSG. Just check gateway MSG. Yeah, MSC. Here you can see this GMSC. So this is one of the very key important factor. So you must have heard about a word, gateway. Gateway MSC. Gateway stands means. See, so here we have two different barriers. One is wireless and another one is wired network. When you want to connect with the two different barriers, then you need gateway. Correct. Suppose assume that you are doing a transaction. I want to just take one example here. When you are doing a transaction between syndicate bank, sorry, the name is Canara Bank, Canara Bank and State Bank. So those are two different branches or banks, separate network, right? How this is done is, there in between there will be a gateway which will be helping for the transaction. Some gateway is responsible for doing that. Similarly, this gateway MSC is performing the gateway function, and it is, you can see here, if you look into this diagram, here you see this is used for connecting the wireless as well as wired networks such as ISDN, PSDN and PDN. Correct. So this is responsible, this is a gateway of MSC is responsible for connecting our wireless network with the wired networks. Okay. So this is one of the very important or a key factor. Next is a home location register. Actually it stores a database or information of that user. Means here this concept will be easily understood in detail when we go for the third unit. So HLR is responsible for storing complete details regarding the user's usage of the data or maybe a voice or a data network. It's complete information. When you purchase any SIM from a particular network, your complete information, what you are entering, you are uploading in your and once uploading, that is stored in HLR and it is connected to your SIM. Means when you use that particular SIM, your complete data will be connected to that SIM and that is stored in HLR. So here when you purchase a SIM, you will be a subscriber. Actually the HLR stores the data or the important information related to that subscriber. So whatever information, your Aadhaar card, your photo, everything, whatever it is linked to your SIM card, that will be stored in HLR. Means whenever your data needs to be accessed by some authorities, they can access it from HLR. Next is a visit location register. It's a temporary database. It's updated when you are going to the new mobile station. So that concept I want to discuss here, otherwise it will be confusing. See, here we have a VSC. See, I will use another diagram where you can get it. Yeah, here. Oh, not this. Here. Yes, here you see. You have two MSCs here, mobile switching center. And what happens when you switch from this network to another network here? Okay, this will be your parent network, and that this will be your what you can say is a sub network or child network. Or you will be shifting from your network to this network. What happens? Your information will be stored in your network. That is stored in your HLR here. Correct? Now, when you visit to a different network, there will be a VLR where your data or entries will be stored. And that will be helpful when somebody calls you. Because someone calls you and when you are in the different network. Suppose assume that you are in Kumta, you have a, your SIM is linked to the Kumta BSC. That is the base switching center, correct? And your all data is stored in this home location register. And when you move from here to some Mangalore or Bangalore, so there it will use a separate network. Then how you will be identified when somebody calls you? First it looks into your network, and from there it will take your care of address and it will go to the another network where you are present. There you need your visited data in your visitor location register will be stored, and by accessing that your call will be connected. And about these things we will be discussing in the upcoming units. There you will get a better idea. This is regarding the network switching subsystem. Now let us discuss about the last part into this GSM architecture, that is operation subsystem. These are mainly, this particular operation system contains facilities related to the network operations and maintenance. So here we have three parts. One is operation and maintenance center, and authentication center, then equipment identity registration register. Now what happens is, this part is mainly used for network operation and maintenance. So first one is operation and maintenance center. Its main task is or its main function is monitoring the traffic, different subscribers, security management and accounting and billing. Means all the these tasks are performed here in operation and maintenance center. Next comes authentication center. It provides provided against the target or interface. It stores information concerned with the security features such as user authentication and encryption. Means whenever user is logged in or logged out, his authentication and encryption techniques, which you will be learning in network security, all these concepts are maintained here. And equipment identity register, and its main task is to track the handset using IMEI number. That is, when if any of your mobile network is, or a mobile handset is stolen, your mobile handset will have a IMEI number which will be registered in this particular equipment identity register. It can be detected by identifying the location, and it can be helpful for blocking your SIM when it is stolen, and when unauthorized access is done, it can be blocked in case of a defective mobiles also. So like that, these are some of the operation subsystems, and here you can see the operation subsystem is connected through MSC. See here, if you see the complete diagram into this one, here you can find that. Here, if you see the complete diagram, the RSS is connected through BSC, and most of this, and BSC is connected with the MSC, mobile switching centers, correct? And the mobile switching center is connected to this EIR, HLR, EIR, then AUC and AMC. This one it is very clear. I just want to go to this here I can see. So here it will be very clear. So when you want to connect from radio switching center, it will be connectivity between BSC, base switching center, and MSC, that is a mobile switching center, and the operation subsystem is connected to MSD. Okay, this is the architecture of GSM.